Are you thinking about moving to Santa Rosa, California?
Hi, I'm Holly. I'm a realtor who was born, raised, and works in the San Francisco North Bay, and I'm going to talk to you about what it's like to move and live to Santa Rosa. Let's get into it. Santa Rosa is the 42 square mile county seat of Sonoma. It's got a population of about 180,000 and is 55 miles north of San Francisco. It's the metropolitan heart of wine country. If you're going to move to Santa Rosa, you want to know about jobs, right? The major employment sectors in the city of Santa Rosa are government, education, healthcare, and hospitality. Local government employees work for the County of Sonoma as the courthouse and county offices are right here off of Highway 101. The City of Santa Rosa is also a major employer, and both of these employers account for roughly 5,600 jobs. Education is another huge sector with the City of Santa Rosa School District, the Santa Rosa Junior College, a network of private K through 12 schools, and some trade schools. Healthcare companies are another major employer, with the heavy hitters being Kaiser Permanente and the St. Joseph Healthcare System, who combined employ about 4,200 people. There are also private practices and several skilled nursing facilities in the city. Hospitality and tourism are huge industries in Santa Rosa, as we are in wine country, and this is a destination for people near and far, whether that's weddings, corporate events, festivals, or vacation. There are at least 30 hotels in Santa Rosa, and so many tasting rooms, vineyards, and wineries, with Kendall Jackson, St. Francis, Manzanita's Creek, and Paradise Ridge being some of the most famous and well-regarded. I cannot begin to count the number of restaurants in Santa Rosa. There is everything from high-end to fast casual. The median price for a rental is about $2,450 monthly, whereas single-family homes so far in 2021 have a median sales price of $700,000, with condos and townhomes coming in at $406,500. Santa Rosa has a variety of home types and styles. There are historical homes built as far back as the late 1800s, and new construction being built as we speak, with everything in between. If you're looking for a very high-end or luxury property, the selection is generally in Northeast Santa Rosa. And if you want to buy a home with acreage or a full-blown vineyard, this is the place to do it. One thing I definitely want to bring up is the possibility of fires. In 2017, one of the most notorious was the Tubbs Fire, which devastated Santa Rosa as well as other parts of Sonoma County, Lake County, and Napa County. Approximately $1.3 billion in damage was done across 37,000 acres. I remember in October of 2017 when that fire started, waking up in the middle of the night in my house in Petaluma, and I thought something inside my house was on fire. The smell of smoke was so strong. There have been several fires that have taken place since then across Northern California, and some of the lasting effects of these fires, aside from the trauma and the damage, is increased insurance costs, as well as an availability of insurance. There's times of the year where if there's a fire going on, a lot of insurances will put a moratorium on certain areas and zip codes. So it can be really difficult to acquire insurance if you're looking to purchase during those times in specific areas. I've had clients where it almost affected them, but it ended up not, so we did work around it. Loss of coverage is also a very real possibility. Every year we hear about certain areas where people who have been customers for like decades just get dropped. Something else to be aware of as a result of the fires are planned safety power shutoffs, or PSPS. That is where PG&E, who is responsible for some of these fires, they cut service to neighborhoods or streets where there is a very high risk of fire. Usually that means a combination of dry climate and high winds. While I don't think the PSPS has affected the North Bay as much this year as in years past. There have been these rolling blackouts that are a result of the PSPS, where some people have been without power for like 5 days. And every year, especially since 2017, and all of these large fires are happening, the air quality can really get bad, and you'll need to wear like an N95 mask to protect yourself or just not go outside. Okay, on to happier subjects. We've talked about living in Santa Rosa. We've talked about working in Santa Rosa. Let's talk about playing in Santa Rosa. There are two large malls in Santa Rosa, the Cottingtown Mall and the Downtown Mall. Both are a little bit past their heyday, but it's still fun to go shopping. There's also Montgomery Village, which has some really good restaurants and little boutiques, and one of my offices is there as well. Downtown Santa Rosa has plenty of events throughout the year, like farmers markets, as well as several locally owned restaurants and boutiques and salons. Another fun and unique thing to do in Santa Rosa is to visit Safari West. This is a 400-acre like wildlife preserve park where they have giraffes, impalas, cheetahs, a ton of other animals that you can see. It's very fun. There are 6 golf courses, some movie theaters, and the Sonoma County Fairgrounds is in Santa Rosa, where you can go to the county fair during the summer, you can bet on horse racing, and Country Summer, which is the largest country music festival in Northern California, takes place here as well. I've told you almost everything there is to know about living in Santa Rosa, so before we finish up, please hit like and give me a subscribe for more San Francisco North Bay content. Now that you're probably convinced that Santa Rosa is the place you need to be, and we've talked about everything going on inside Santa Rosa, how are you getting out of Santa Rosa? Like I've said, Santa Rosa is 55 miles north of San Francisco via 101 South, and you can either drive there or take the Golden Gate Transit buses, which drive directly into San Francisco, or you can take it to the Larkspur Ferry Terminal and take the ferry from Larkspur to the ferry building in San Francisco, which is fun itself, but then you can get out and get into basically the financial district. Lyft and Uber have a pretty strong presence in Santa Rosa as well, but there are local taxi companies that you can call too. The Smart Train has 3 stations in Santa Rosa. The last stop on the ride right now is actually the last stop in Santa Rosa as well, which drops off about a mile from the Sonoma County Airport. The airport currently has flights with Alaska Airlines, American Airlines, United, and Avelo. Since the Sonoma County Airport is in Santa Rosa, you can fly directly from Santa Rosa to Portland, Seattle, LA, Orange County, Las Vegas, San Diego, Dallas, Denver, Burbank, San Francisco, I think that's it, but you could also just take the airport or bus to SFO, whatever you want to do. So I've pretty much told you everything there is to know about living in Santa Rosa. Please give me a call, text, or shoot me an email if you're planning on living or buying in the city. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.